Welcome back to Glasgow News. Still Friday the 11th of January, and we're the Daily Record online page. I'm looking here a wee bit of controversy that's popped up after Barry Ferguson's Record Sport opinion piece sparked a bit of debate on the sports hotline at the Daily Record. People phoning in and stuff. But anyway, the headline is Rangers are miles off being as good as Class 2011 and Celtic will romp title. And that was apparently something that was said during the hotline. So let's go on to see some of the comments. It said here, Record Sport columnist Barry Ferguson believes Rangers are Rangers again, and it triggered a hotline furore. Well, furore. For all the BAMs out there, is a fuss. You know. I was reading another story the other day. It was in the Record, and they said somebody was coerced into shagging their dog. You know, so coerced means forced. Why don't you just say forced? Turned out it wasn't forced, but never mind. Anyway, so Fraser Davidson of Glasgow said, "I wholeheartedly agree with Barry. Barry's assumption that Rangers are back to being Rangers. They're still living beyond their means, up to their eyeballs in debt, and still on course for administration again, at the rate they are burning through money. Half the team is now made up of Rangers men who scarpered off when admin came round the first time. I hope the Rangers fans are not back to being the fans who fell for it the last time." Next guy is a guy called Eddie Eason. He said, "Barry can say what he wants about Rangers. In the eyes of the world, they won't be back until they have won a trophy." That's a good point, Eddie. "Are they now trying to re-sign Stephen Naismith? Then all the money grabbers who the so-called fans detested would all be back." He's making, assertions that the Stephen Naismith guy pissed off because Rangers couldn't pay him any money. And when I say any money, no, they didn't have any money to pay him. That's actually a fact. Right, okay. And he's got a point there. Tom McAllister emailed in, "I think fellow Celtic fans should give credit where it's due." I can feel a tongue-in-cheek one coming up here. "For a new club to be close to Celtic at this stage of the season is a good achievement. Celtic, of course, will win the second half of the season and motor ahead, but Rangers could even get a European spot ahead of the rest of the draws." Okay. Scott Patterson Fervin said, "Rangers fans, including Ferguson, are getting way ahead of themselves after only one win over Celtic in 13 attempts. He's comparing the current team to the one which won the title in 2011, but they are miles away from that team. I can't wait for the season to restart, so Rangers once again prove it's a false dawn and Celtic put their foot down and win the title by a handsome margin." Other matters were up for the debate during this hotline. David Bryce of Ayr said, "I see Yusuf Malumbu is set to leave Celtic after three appearances, but it does not surprise me in the slightest. Our signings policy is bonkers, and I can't remember the last time I was excited by a Celtic signing. If we don't win the league this year, the fans will be absolutely up in arms. And the frustrating thing is, we have done this to ourselves. We should be years ahead of Rangers, but due to the negligence of the board and the manager's inability to buy good players, there is no gap." Well, I don't know about that. You know, look at the amount of titles you've just won. Look how far ahead you've been all these years. Your board, the Celtic board, there's nothing wrong with the Celtic board. You just don't have any debt. I think the people that run Celtic are pretty clued up, to be honest. I mean, you can have bad signings injuries and guys that don't work out, but I think Brendan Rodgers is an excellent manager. But anyway, let's move on. Jim Maxwell from Perth had Alfredo Morelos in his target when he said, "Morelos seems to get away with anything, so Donald Trump should be his new nickname, as they are both seemingly untouchable." Well, Jim, that's pish. That just isn't even fucking funny, you know. Sorry about the language, boys. But anyway, Gordon Ashley for Ayr went after Chris Sutton and commented, "Chris Sutton should keep..." He's really what he's saying is, "Chris Sutton should keep his mouth shut." Celtic fans were unanimous on the blogs that we shouldn't go near Jermaine Defoe. Rangers are wasting yet more cash, and our move for Issuf Bayo is the best buy. We'll get 20 million for him in 3 years' time. Up next, an unhappy Partick Thistle fan. Is there anything other than unhappy Partick Thistle fans? Craig Young, in Glasgow, said, "Dunfermline have pleased their fans in appointing club legend Stevie Crawford as boss, and it will see the fans coming back in droves. On the other hand, the Partick Thistle board dived in to name Gary Caldwell, and it's been a disaster with fans leaving in droves. Gary isn't the answer, and we shouldn't compound the mistake. He needs to go immediately." Oh, fuck Gary. That's your mortgage under fucking pressure. And finally, a few calls on the new Andy Murray. And the news, Andy Murray is about to hang up his tennis racket. No, I don't like tennis. Tennis is shite, so I'm not even going to go there. Right, okay, guys. So that was a few calls to the hotline. Hope you liked that. That's all for now. Peace out.